Atomic oxygen sounds like an element that was exposed to radiation in the 1930s and became a comic book superhero. But that's my idea, okay? I could make millions. Hey Atomic Avengers, Ian here for D News. So scientists recently spotted atomic oxygen on Mars. Although the Mariner and Viking missions also discovered the stuff in the 1960s and 70s, this time it was detected from Earth by an awesome flying telescope. The Sofia Telescope is a partnership between NASA and the German Aerospace Center. It's basically a converted Boeing 747SP with a 2.5 meter diameter infrared telescope poking out the back. Yes, a telescope about the same diameter as the Hubble Space Telescope, flying on a jumbo jet high above most of the Earth's atmosphere. So cool. But what is atomic oxygen and why does it matter on Mars? Well, oxygen is highly reactive, so it tends to bond to other molecules. So we breathe oxygen, we're actually breathing the most common form of oxygen, O2. But when oxygen atoms exist by themselves, chemists refer to it as atomic oxygen. Atomic oxygen is formed when ultraviolet radiation from the sun hits water molecules on Mars' surface. The energy of this impact spits out an oxygen atom from the H2O molecule that sends the hydrogen component high into the atmosphere, which is eventually lost to space. It can also be produced from interactions with carbon dioxide molecules in the atmosphere. These free oxygen atoms quickly grab onto lots of other different chemicals like carbon, chlorine, nitrogen, and even other oxygen atoms, creating breathable O2 molecules. Atomic oxygen is rare at sea level on Earth because it will quickly bond with pretty much anything. But if we look at low Earth orbit at around 400 kilometers high, atomic oxygen makes up 96% of the atmosphere. Though very thin at these altitudes, the atomic oxygen gas is so reactive that during the first shuttle flights, it was eroding and damaging the orbiter's hull coatings, forcing NASA to use a different formula that was less reactive. Anyway, detecting atomic oxygen on Mars could tell us a lot about the atmosphere, its history, and possibly provide clues as to whether or not Mars can sustain microbial life on its surface, or if it ever did. Also, you know why Mars' surface is so rusty? The red color is created by a coating of iron oxide. Nope, even iron isn't safe from the atomic oxygen's passion to bond. Sofia is now giving us a global view of the whole of Mars, and by taking many 8-hour flights to stare at the planet, we're able to understand how atomic oxygen changes in time. In addition, Sofia has detected ozone in the high Martian atmosphere, which is a molecule of 3 oxygen atoms and a gas that is really good at blocking ultraviolet light that can damage life. For any possible Mars microbes, the more ozone, the better. Ozone was actually detected on Mars in the 1970s, and more recently by the European Mars Express mission. In a paper published by Nature Geoscience, researchers found that an ozone layer occasionally forms over the southern pole. Atmospheric currents and complex chemical interactions are at play on Mars that don't occur on Earth. These findings are not only useful for understanding the diversity of atmospheric chemistry on planets in our solar system, it also provides a wonderful insight to the possible interactions of very alien worlds orbiting other stars. And that's not all. Mars used to be a lot warmer and wetter than it is now, conditions that scientists think were habitable for microbial life. So by understanding how the different types of oxygen evolve over time, we can gain an insight to how much breathable oxygen, O2, and how much ozone, O3, was around in Mars's past. And this can possibly help us understand if life as we know it could still be hiding under the red planet's rusty rocks. So could aliens be living on Mars? Check out this video from our friends over at All Time Conspiracies to find out more.
Lowell found evidence of water vapor in Mars's atmosphere, and he thought this proved that these Martian canals were an underground water system used to sustain life beneath the planet's surface. This theory captivated the public's imagination for years.
Would you like to see a D News episode about the awesome Sofia Telescope? Tell us in the comments section below, and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every day of the week. And I'll see you next time on D News.